ain't trying to fit in with them. By the way, I dare Kenneth Copeland to take me to court and sue me for what I'm about to say. He is a 33rd degree Mason. He is in the Masonic Satanic cult.
If you go into a Google search of Kenneth Copeland Freemasonry, there are hundreds of proofs. Not one proof. Hundreds of proofs that the New Apostolic Reformation, including Kenneth Copeland, including Bill Johnson, including Todd White, including Todd Bentley, including every single one of the leadership, they are Freemasons who knowingly worship Lucifer as God. That's why they have you singing Shekinah Glory. Shekinah is Lucifer.
Hi guys, it's Aaron, transformed by his truth. I wanted to read from another article, which, you know, I always read these articles before I post them. I always say, but I had forgotten to say on some of my comments to the folks that were trying to make sense of their dreams and visions, which are not for today. I forgot to put a disclaimer on there that I don't necessarily agree with everything on the websites or channels that I read from, just the articles that I'm reading from themselves. So I want to make that clear. Here's a good one about Kenneth Copeland, him being a 33rd degree Mason, and the proof to back it up. So, this makes me very happy. I knew it already, but I'm so happy to have been able to find this article because he's such a liar. And he's a satanic-filled antichrist man that is deceiving millions. Anyway, let's go into this article. It says, oh, it's by How to Become a Christian infoblog.com. Okay, so in this article, we will attempt for the first time to unveil the truth of Kenneth Copeland's Masonic membership. As Kenneth is a closet secret Freemason who does not want anyone to know this truth, it will be a involving task that needs to look deeply into specific clues. It is the trademark of most proud Masons to leave key symbols veiled in pictures and also to use various keywords in speeches or secret handshakes. Proof of this can be found in Masonry's most common definition of itself as being Freemasonry. Freemasonry is a peculiar system of morality veiled in allegory and illustrated by symbols. This is taken directly from the second degree initiation, and evidence that it is still currently used was proven to me recently when I attended a Masonic Open Day and heard that same description. The application of this quote in regards to Copeland will be discussed below. Kenneth Copeland started his ministry under Oral Roberts, 33rd degree Freemason, as a pilot, airplane pilot. Kenneth was on TV sometime around June of 1997 praising Oral Roberts as they were close friends. Evidence that Oral Roberts is a 33rd degree Mason will be compiled and published as soon as possible. Well, I don't need this article to tell me that he was a Freemason too. I've looked him up. But I don't have that article in front of me, but I've done my research. So, anyway, Kenneth Copeland chants the words, I am, which is a Masonic initiation term. And I say this with all respect, and this is a quote from him, so that it don't upset you too bad, but I say it anyway. When I read in the Bible where he says, I am, I just smile and say, yes, I am too. Believer, that makes me sick to even say that. It's such a blasphemy. That's quoted from Believer's Voice of Victory broadcast, July 9th, 1987. You know, I used to get the Believer's Voice of Victory magazine, and so I know all this junk. He said, I get very frustrated because I've come out of it, thankfully, but people that I love and care about have not. And I want to expose him for exactly what he is, so hopefully they will. During the ceremonies of a Masonic ritual for the Royal Arch degree, the candidate is asked, "Brother Inspector, what are you?" And he replies, "I am that I am." When Jesus told the Jews before Abraham was, "I am," he was claiming to be the God of Moses who went by that name. This is why they tried to...
Hey guys, gonna cut in here for a second. If you would like to understand that the I am teachings of Lucifer, exactly how they work, the New Age movement is the actual vehicle that's being used to bring in what's going on. Lucifer is the ascended master Saint Germain, and if you would like to figure out how the I am a little god, the actual roots of it, you would need to go to a guy whose name is Peter Mount Shasta. Peter Mount Shasta. And he is Lucifer's number one trainer as far as the I Am movement is concerned. He and I have had probably between 20 and 40 hours of personal in my antique shop, in McLeod, in the McLeod Mercantile, where he and I have had conversations. So if you go and look up Peter Mount Shasta, he will show you the actual Freemasonic, New Age, fallen angels, ascended masters, what the I Am teachings are that Bill Johnson and the entire New Apostolic Reformation are teaching. It's Freemasonry. It is worship of Lucifer.
Tell him immediately. Kenneth is claiming to be a god. 33rd degree Freemason Robert Schuller also endorses his followers to chant I Am. The quote, "The most effective mantras employ the M sound. You can get the feel of it by repeating the words I am many times over." Transcendental meditation or TM is not a religion, nor is it necessarily anti-Christian. You know, I told my mom about him and she quickly got away. You know, he's such a liar. Sitting there talking about... anyway, you know, he and Billy Graham became even better friends after Billy said that there are many ways to heaven. And I've done another video by Bill on Billy Graham, so please look it up under False Teachers and False Prophets. And there's plenty of articles and proof. Peace of mind through... what Robert Schuller said was from Peace of Mind Through Possibility Thinking, page 131 to 32. Benny Hinn, who I suspect is a Freemason, I know he is, also tells Christians to chant, "I am." "Don't tell me you have Jesus." This is a quote from him. "Don't tell me you have Jesus. You are everything he was and everything he is and ever shall be." This is gross. "Don't say I have, say I am, I am, I am, I am, I am." Ugh. That's a end quote. Our Position in Christ, number 2, The Word Made Flesh audio tape, side 2 from 1991. Kenneth Copeland has stated that Jehovah means half male, half female, and that God is as much female as he is male. Well, let me let you know, folks, that Baphomet, that the satanic people worship, including the Freemasons, is a hermaphrodite. Look at...
Okay, so what she's talking about right now is, we're going to start right here. Freemasonry, all of their teachings are based on the Kabbalah. The Kabbalah is the scripturally referenced doctrine of devils, or doctrine of demons. And inside the Kabbalah, they teach you to be able to control the fallen angels, and you're using their Hebrew names. So they are using the Tree of Life, the Kabbalah tree, with the sephirot, the little spherical things, when all of the New Apostolic Reformation leaders are teaching about portals, these are the portals they're using. They are simply calling the fallen angels and the demons. The demons are the disembodied spirits of the Nephilim. The Nephilim are the results of the fallen angels mating with women. So, what the New Apostolic Reformation is doing is teaching you how to control these things. Now, the Kenneth Copeland teaching that God is male and female is also Kabbalah. This comes from a teaching that's called Adam Kadmon. I have an entire video that explains Adam Kadmon and how it connects to the Kabbalah and why Chris Vallotton teaching that God is male and female and turns the Holy Spirit, the Ruach Kokadesh, and takes the Holy Spirit and turns it into the Shekinah, which is Lucifer. So what the Freemasons are doing inside of these churches is teaching you to worship Lucifer veiled. When they are singing Shekinah Glory, they are waiting for Shekinah to show up. They are waiting for Lucifer to show up.
Baphomet, and you're going to be offended because it's a very ugly, statuesque thing, but it is half male, half female. It's the duality. It's the black and white. It's the, you know, I've done my research. I know exactly what I'm talking about. They're all Freemasons.
Inside Reading, we got charged, what, $26 million to build a Baphomet worship bridge. That sundial is, if you go and look up sundials, it has to do with Nimrod and his penis. And the vagina has to do with Semiramis. And then if you look at the design of Redding's sundial bridge, it is a penis with a vagina at the bottom. The bridge has been made white to simulate semen. And at the end of the bridge is a brass sphere that will symbolize an egg. And if you go and look at who designed the bridge, the logo for Santiago Calatrava is a Templar cross. So when Bethel came and said that they were coming in the name of that God gave them our town, then they put their people in charge of our town, then the fruit of their actions is that we now have a Templar Baphomet worship location in our town that is bringing millions of people into our town to worship a penis and a vagina. Let that sink in.
Born, all of them. Anyway, so yeah, that's where they get the half male, half female thing. That's such a... He amplifies the strange teaching by also saying that Adam was originally half male and half female. You know, anybody who reads the Bible can see that that's not true. And if you have the Holy Spirit in you, he's going to get very offended by that. According to the book, The Secret Teachings of Freemasonry by Gordon Mohr, M-O-H-R, this is exactly what the Masonic Lodge teaches on pages 107 to 108. In his first initiation, this is what it says there. In his first initiation stages, he, the Freemason, learns, 1. That the rite of initiation for apprentice Masons represents in dramatic fashion the origin or birth of nature's God, the Great All. It signifies the non-existence of a supernatural person God, such as that of Christianity. It signifies that the two principles of matter and form, male and female, are always eternally generating, reproducing. It looks on God as a hermaphrodite, and creation is the beginning of the generation process, unquote. Taken from Speculative Masonry by Brother J. York, Grandmaster of the Ancient Rite, pages 3 and 54. 2. The initiation rite into the second degree represents the moral condition of nature's God. Always in labor, always reproducing. Again, it looks on God as a hermaphroditic and states that his name Jehovah means generation, meaning to say he, she, the two sexes in one. This is from Speculative Masonry, page 14, and Mackey's Lexion, L-E-X-I-O-N, pages 126 to 129. The dual principle of male and female is represented by the square and compass. The compass represents Osiris, the male god of the Egyptians, while the square is the symbol representing Isis, the female goddess of Egypt. Both are sexual symbols. This is taken from Ragon's course. R-A-G-O-N apostrophe S, C-O-U-R-S, period. Philosophique, page 102. This reference to the square and compass is significant as Copeland has placed these symbols on one of his tape covers. In Freemasonry, symbols and...
So this is the book cover that she's referencing. And, see if I can clean this up a little bit. See the compass and the square. So the square and compass. The compass is orange. Orange is the only number in numerology that is 33, and so Freemasons hide themselves using orange as their logo, just like Stephen Furtick has the chevron and the orange as his logos.
Signs are of ultimate importance. They talk to each other through leaving their little symbols on all their different little things. You know, if you start looking into all that, you'll be blown away by how many are all over everything we see every day. Copeland teaches similar things that the early Mormon leaders, who are also Freemasons, taught. While the Mormons teach that God lives on a planet near the star Kolob, Copeland says that his hermaphroditic God also lives on a mother planet. Mother planet. So, quote, heaven has a north and a south and an east and a west. Consequently, it must be a planet. Spirit. That's from Spirit, Soul, and Body 1, 1985, audio tape number 01-0601, side 1. I love that there's references for all of this. You don't think, oh, so quote again, you don't think Earth was first, do you? Huh? Well, you don't think that God made man in his image and then made Earth in some other image. There is not anything under this whole sun that's new. Are you hearing what I'm saying? This is all a copy. It's a copy of home. Planet where God lives. He made a little one just like his and put us on it. From Following the Faith of Abraham 1, 1989 audio tape number 01-3001, side 1. Alright, compare what Freemason Mormon Brigham Young stated. Quote, Adam is our father and our God. With Copeland's quote, Adam in the Garden of Eden was God manifested in the flesh. From Following the Faith of Abraham, 1, side 1. There's more. I don't know if you need more, but there's a whole bunch more. Also compare Freemason Mormon founder Joseph Smith's teaching that if you were to see God today, quote, you would see him like a man in form, like yourselves in all the person, image, and very form as a man, with Copeland's following description of his God. Copeland describes God as, quote, a being that is very uncanny, the way he's very much like you and me, a being that stands somewhere around 6'2 or 6'3, that weighs somewhere in the neighborhood of a couple hundred pounds or a little better, has a span of 9 inches across, unquote. Spirit, Soul, and Body, 1, audio tape side 1, 1985. I never heard him say this stuff. You know, if I had, I would have been so far away from him. God spoke Adam into existence in authority and words. These words struck Adam's body in the face. His body and God were exactly the same size, unquote. That's from the Holy Bible, Kenneth Copeland Reference Edition, 1991, 45, emphasis in original. Just unbelievable, this garbage. Adam was the copy. He looked just like God. So this is a quote. Adam was the copy. He looked just like God. If you stood Adam upside God, they look exactly alike. If you stood Jesus and Adam side by side, they would look and sound exactly alike. That's from Authority of the Believer 4, Roman numeral 4, 1987 audio tape number 01-0304, side 1. On the cover of Copeland's audio tape series entitled How to Build Your Firm Foundation, remember the main definition of Masonry as being Freemasonry is a peculiar system of morality veiled in allegory and illustrated by symbols. This is exactly what we have right here. Copeland has placed the chief Masonic symbols of the square and compass here, that to most people, the true meaning is veiled is in an allegorical style. So allegory means a fictional literary narrative or artistic expression that conveys a symbolic meaning parallel to, but distinct from, and more important than the literal meaning. Allegory has also been defined as an extended metaphor. The symbolic meaning is usually expressed through personifications and other symbols in art. An allegorical painting or sculpture is one that has a symbolic meaning underlying the surface image. Sorry, I'm trying to do this without blocking the screen, but trying not to look down. More symbols of Freemasonry are incorporated into Copeland's Shout magazine for kids. Around Kenneth's neck is an eagle above an inverted triangle. I have seen this symbol on a Masonic certificate before. The female has an inverted five-pointed star placed on her shirt. This symbol represents the Order of the Eastern Star, which is a Masonic order for women. Is this a coincidence? No, of course not. Now, Copeland has placed the main symbols of Masonry and the Eastern Star on his covers. When 33rd degree Freemason Robert Schuller wanted to express his secret membership in the Lodge, he used the 33rd degree symbol of a double-headed eagle, and it sent it out to many people without them realizing what he was declaring to his Masonic brothers worldwide. 33rd degree Mason Oral Roberts used the inverted triangle in his university logo, which has a hidden Masonic design to it. Another odd element is that the Freemasons veiled the symbol of the square compass, inverted star, and triangle in the street layout of Washington, D.C. These are the three symbols that Copeland has placed on the two mentioned covers. As I write this, he is presently, well, not anymore. I guess he went to Washington to conduct a rally at that time. To summarize, Kenneth Copeland started work under a 33rd degree Freemason whom he has a strong friendship with. He claims to be I Am, which is a Masonic initiation term, not to mention blasphemy. His teachings about his hermaphroditic God match up exactly with what Masonry teaches, and his teaching on the size and likeness of God match up with what the early Freemason Mormon leaders also taught. Add to this the veiled symbols of Freemasonry that he's placed on his two covers, possibly more. I would never have suspected Copeland of being a Freemason if it were not for his heretical teachings, including his belief that God was gang-raped and sodomized by homosexual Roman soldiers. How could he even say those things? If so, then God's blood would be impure and unable to redeem. Please click on the link below for more information on Copeland's false teachings and strange beliefs. And that is www.theforbiddenknowledge.com/hardtruth/Kenneth Copeland, 33rd degree Freemason. Please look it up. Or you can look at all the videos that I've given and put plenty of information about him on there. The deciding factor to publish this information came after a friend of mine received information from an ex-Mason that stated that he had been in attendance in a Masonic meeting when Copeland was present. Not to mention, I'm sure he was in one of the satanic ritualistic things they do. Look up the origin of Freemasonry and start doing your research. It's disgusting. They're just like Satanists because they are. They all worship Satan, who they refer to as Lucifer, but he's not anymore. He lost that title when he was thrown out of heaven. Rightfully so. I get so mad. I'm Irish, so it comes out. But I'm righteously mad. I'm indignant with satanic garbage. And we're okay. It's okay to be angry. It's sin. And this is all sin. Okay, so at the moment, this man does not wish to reveal himself. He possibly has some firm documented evidence that we will try to obtain. I do not know who this man is, but my friend is trying to obtain him, blah, 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 blah. You know, they probably would kill this man, because if you look at the oath that a Freemason has to take, a 33rd degree Mason, it talks about having your throat slit, your innards ripped out, horrible things. They put a dagger to their heart and they do all these things. It's sick. But they're not joking. They will kill you if they find out, or they can find you and get away with it, because they don't want people to know the truth. Freemasonry at the upper levels, which is 33rd degree or higher, they take an oath to reject Jesus Christ, knowing they are told exactly who he is, because they know, all those satanic worshipers, they know who Jesus is. And they have chosen to reject him and follow Satan. So they tell these people the gospel, and they tell them now you must reject it to become a 33rd degree Mason. So those people who are 33rd degree Masons, they have rejected the gospel. They know what they're doing. They lay in coffins and horrible sexual things are done. It's just sick. So there's nothing good about Freemasonry. It's a cover for another satanic occult group, a very large one. And, you know, unfortunately, it's worldwide, and it's all of the elite are Freemasons who worship Lucifer, Satan, and who are so happy right now, because they know that their Antichrist leader's coming. They know he's around the corner. They know, as soon as the rapture happens, that they have free reign. The demons and the fallen angels know it too, and they're gonna kill people as fast as they can, because they hate God's creation. Anyway, I do want to go into a little bit more about Freemasonry. You know, secret societies are looked on as a fraternal type of thing, or, you know, some good old boys clubs and garbage like that, but it's not. They're for real. You know, they start with trying to get these kids in college. They try to get, you know, these sororities and fraternities. They pick certain kids that they think are vulnerable or will work well in their system, and they start going after them.
I grew up, mom and dad got married, and yeah, so anyway, all the way through my life, about 11 years old, they ended up, no Christianity in my family. They got divorced, and by 11 and a half, my mom, like, she couldn't handle me. I was rebellious, I was rowdy, there was no Christianity in my family the whole way around. So I went to a place called the Masonic Home, and I grew up there for about 5.5 years in a place where the Freemasons sponsor it. I went in there and I was fully addicted by 12. At 17, I ended up just
addicted to what?
Addicted to everything. I needed whatever I could get to make me feel better.
Wow.
Whether it was pornography, whether it was acid, mushrooms, whatever was out, I did it. I was afraid of needles, so I never went that route, but everything I could get. So I got out of the home, got kicked out, came home. My mom had remarried, and she was with my stepdad. Afraid of needles, so I never went that route, but everything I could get. So I got out of the home, got kicked out, came home. My mom had remarried, and she was with my stepdad, and no one could be my dad, you know. And I was out there, man, to a place called the Masonic Homes and Rooms, whatever was out, I did it. I was afraid where the Freemasons sponsor it.
Thank you.
service and leadership skills, Masonic youth groups help the kids of today prepare for a better tomorrow.
Masonic fraternities inside Redding, California. Sorry, it's really fuzzy, but Jay didn't get a good copy of that one. Those kids had the fist up to the sky, the same way.
Skills I've learned every day.
Tomorrow, discover more at MasonicYouthGroups.com.
See that fist in the sky? Notice how Trump does that all the time too? That's a sign of rebellion to God. They are Luciferians. They worship the devil.
Angie is going to become the Grand Bethel Honored Queen of Job's Daughters. Angie, thanks for being out here today.
Thanks for having me.
This is going to become the Grand Bethel Honored Queen of Job's Daughters. This is going to become the Grand Bethel Honored Queen of Job's Daughters. This is going to become the Grand Bethel Honored Queen of Job's.
So, inside the symbology, the semiology, the semiotics, they will use sigil magic to be able to hide things inside their logos. If you look at the letter B on the building right here, you will notice that the stem of the B is completely separated at the top and the bottom. That is the number 13. The number 13 is synonymous with the Templars, and everything at Bethel is Templar related. Now, in sigil magic, the vowels are removed. In simple sigil magic, vowels are removed. And so, whoever was designing this logo put the three long lines for the T, the H, and the L to be the 3 9-inch nails that crucified Jesus. That's the number 666 in Hebrew, just the same as the Monster Energy Drinks logo is a 666. These people are hiding who they are. They are simply Templar Freemasons who worship Lucifer as God. They are worshiping the Ascended Master Saint Germain as God. That's who they are following.
Daughters gonna become the Grand Bethel Honored Queen of Job's Daughters. Gonna become the Grand Bethel Honored Queen. Thing called Job's Daughters.
Okay, scripture says that judgment starts in the house of God. House is Beth in Hebrew, and God is El. So house of God is Bethel, and Bethel is where judgment is going to start. So the occultists intentionally named their occultism for things that they know mean that later on in life that the judgment of God is going to come down on the people that are following inside this group.
Masons in Michigan are curious about it because they've never been to a meeting of Job Stutters. Tell me, what's a Job Stutter?
A Job Stutter is a girl between the age of 10 and 20.
Okay, is that it? Is that it? Does she have any Masonic affiliation?
Yes, she has to be related to a Master Mason to be in Job Stutters.
As we know, Freemasonry is a system of education that uses symbolism and allegory to teach a virtuous code of conduct.
And that's how you learned about Job Stutters from your father?
Yes, my grandfather was a Mason also, but I did learn it from my father because I'd never knew my grandfather.
Great.
Excellent. So tell us a little bit.
Because I'd never knew my grandfather.
Great.
Excellent. So tell us a little bit.
I kind of describe Job Stutters in a weird way, and I say it's a mix between a sorority and Girl Scouts.
Okay, for a second we have to stop. Remember that everything is veiled in allegory, right? See that flag behind her? See the yellow fringe around the side of it? That means that we're under maritime law. We are under the law of the sea. The Constitution is suspended any time that yellow fringe is on the flag. We are not under constitutional law. We are under maritime law. And the beast of the sea would be the first beast, which means that yellow fringe will have to come off whenever they switch to the New World Order. That yellow fringe will come off and we will switch to the beast of the earth. And then the beast of the sea will get a head wound. Oh wait, do I have that right? One of the beasts gets a head wound, the second beast tells us to worship the first beast. So that yellow fringe will be coming off the flag soon.
Girl Scouts, but we don't sell cookies.
So, like, you have local groups of Job Stutters. What are they called?
Bethels.
Cool.
Bethels.
Cool. I want to come and visit a Job Stutters Bethel, and as a Mason, I've never been, so what do I have to do?
What do you mean? What do you have to do?
Do I have to do anything special to show up to a meeting? Excellent. All right. So the girls, when I come and visit a Job Stutters Bethel, what do I expect the girls to look like and how do they act and how many are there? So tell us a little bit about Job's. How come we're here this weekend? What's going on?
Well, this is our grand session and it's an annual meeting place. Obviously meet here once a year, annual meeting place, okay. Well, basically, the real purpose of this grand session is to elect the new Grand Bethel Junior Princess, which is a state officer who will be moving up the line to eventually be what I'm going to be starting tomorrow, Grand Bethel Honor Queen.
Oh, so wait, you were elected to this Grand Bethel Junior Princess. How long have you been doing this?
It's a 3-year line, so
3 years.
2 years ago I was elected.
So do you get to travel any?
Yes. I actually went to Canada, which is the farthest I've gone with Joe's, but yeah, for an Amaranth meeting with the Job's. They were doing the light across there.
So, like, you have local groups of Job Stutters. What are they called?
Bethels.
Cool. I want to come and visit a Job Stutters Bethel, and as a Mason, I've never been, so...
themselves high places in all their towns. from watchtower to fortify the city. That specific building is Bethel's Alabaster Prayer House. They even talk about that they've made themselves... Bill Johnson says that he has built himself a high place in Redding. He is specifically talking about the Alabaster Prayer House while he's doing that conversation. These occultists are doing everything out in plain sight that Scripture tells us they will be doing, and they are leading the sheep astray. They are completely consuming people who claim to be Christians but are not following the teachings of Yeshua HaMashiach. They are following the teachings of the Kabbalah taught by Chris Vallotton, Bill Johnson, Heidi Baker, Chris Cruz that just took over. All of these guys, every single one of them, are teaching you to worship Lucifer. That's what Freemasons do. They've taken the word of God and they have twisted it to make it Freemasonry, and they're teaching it to you. And you're falling for it, and you're giving them money for their hypnotism shows. And Todd White's leg lengthening. They told us about the leg lengthening thing in Colorado at YWAM's youth explosion in 1994. This has been going on since then, at least. Talking about this, he mentions that he's going to be out of town and that he's bummed that he's not going to be in town to be able to go to this Planet Shaker event with Evans. And there's only two Masonic, actual physical Masonic lodges in Redding, and they're both on Masonic Drive. One's the big one that's been retired, and the second one has been moved just about, 120 feet away from the original building. And that building lines up with the ley lines that line up with the giant zodiac that's at the southwest foot. If you use Google satellite views, you can see a giant zodiac at the southwest foot of Black Butte, which is a volcanic chimney of Mount Shasta. The New Agers call that the root chakra of the Kabbalistic globe Earth. The Luciferians invented the globe Earth. If you want to see what Bill Johnson is trying to show you with his graven images, go look inside the Alabaster Prayer House, and in the middle of the compass that's on the floor, which can be replaced for the square and compass, there is a graven image of a globe Earth. Inside that building is designed on 8 pillars. That would be the Shekinah, the house that the sun, the physical sunshine, lives in. It's called Shekinah, and all of this stuff can be proven. You just got to do your research. So if you go and look, that Shekinah building, Shekinah is also Lucifer, is Venus. It's another name for Venus. Venus is another name for Lucifer. That building is a Lucifer worship temple. These people are worshiping the devil and stealing our town.
Thank you. which is the food we bring in.
Come on. Go hang out with, I don't know how many thousands it is now. There's an earthquake under my feet.
Let's back that up for a second. Transformation Center? See that? That's Bethel's, well, actually, where the school cap is, Bethel School is the Transformation Center. The building right next to it that has that name that says Transformation Center on it, right next to Bethel is a tattoo shop. Right next to that is Legacy. Do you remember that from Heidi Baker? Legacy Furniture is right there. Freemasons use that word legacy to be able to hide themselves. They are doing things intentionally to kill our town. They're stealing our town. That canyon behind Bethel's Transformation Center is Sulphur Canyon. That is a very well-known generational place where human sacrifice has been made for at least 200 years that we can prove through hand-me-down stories of locals. Where we know there are several places that are very, very occult. Sulphur Canyon is one of those places. And that's one of the reasons, because it's on that ley line, it's one of the reasons that Sulphur Canyon's important, why the Masonic Lodge is there, and why Bethel picked that spot. I'm not trying to get a copyright strike. It's IHOP's security there, and that's their logo. So, I don't have a good shot of it, but Kenneth, inside that shirt, has a lot of geometric logos that would end up indicating who he's part of a group of. Also, on his shoulder, there is a tight, I'm pretty sure the way that they describe this is, it's a rose, it's has to do with Lucifer, but that rose is also tied to the Catholic Church. It kind of looks like a four-leaf clover, but it's not. Todd White wears a lot of shirts that have hidden satanic symbols inside of him, including the Baphomet head, including Moloch, is inside his shirt design. You can go and find it. On the same day he's wearing that shirt, he's talking about children being kidnapped at Bethel. This isn't Christianity, folks. This is emotionalism. It is simply hypnotism, and it's easy to be able to duplicate. 14 years I spent in the Nashville music industry. Every bit of this fake Holy Spirit that you're feeling right now is hypnotism. I can do the exact same thing. I can lead you through a worship set that starts around 70 beats per minute and be able to ramp it up and be able to get you into a hallucinogenic state where you're feeling absolutely euphoric, where you can feel like you're floating, like your head is, like, just, it feels like you just sucked on some helium and some funny gas. That's how it's easy to do.